Next, we have PPREV140, Sakshi Bhatt. Sakshi, please unmute yourself and open your webcam and start the presentation.
Hello.
Yes, yeah. Sakshi, you are audible.
Good evening, one and all. I'm Sakshi Bhatt from Mallareddy Institute of University of Pharmaceutical Sciences, Hyderabad. My topic is about the development of peptide for drug-resistant antibiotics. So I have selected this topic because all over the world, there are millions of people who are mainly dying due to antibiotic resistance. So this led the scientists to develop antimicrobial peptides, which are also called as host defensive peptides. And they are available from many sources, and their mechanism of action is very rapid. So there are many organisms in our body which are resistant to antibiotic. So when even if we give antibiotic, they'll become resistant and they'll not be able to cure themselves. So the peptides are developed. The sources of peptide, they may be natural or synthetic. So they are available from various sources. And when they both are given in combination, they show synergistic effect, due to which the bacteria will not show any resistance and it will be easy for the bacteria to die. So unlike antibiotics, these antimicrobial peptides, they damage the cell membrane of the bacteria and they destroy the bacterial cell. So there are many organisms which are resistant. So even if one bacteria is resistant in our body, they may transfer the gene to another antibiotics, which will lead to the resistance. So when we give these peptides, this will not happen. And the main mechanism of action is these antimicrobial peptides are positively charged, whereas the bacterial cell membrane is negatively charged. So they both, what happens is the positively charged peptide interacts with the negatively charged bacterial cell wall, and they undergo the membrane and they damage the bacterial cell. Apart from these, they also act as immunomodulators, which means they activate our immune system and thereby they promote angiogenesis, and therefore they increase the immunity, which will help to fight against the microorganisms or bacteria which is present in our body. So these antimicrobial peptides are mainly of four types: alpha helix, beta sheet, extended and loop. Of which alpha helix and beta sheet are mainly used. Ma'am, can you scroll down? So the examples of alpha helix are protegrin, marginin, cyclic indolecin, coiled indolecin. And coming to beta helix, they are gramicidin S, hepicidin, and defensins. So mechanism of action, as I have said, they damage the bacterial cell membrane, and also they act as immunomodulators. They only act against the bacterial cell and they do not affect the host cell, because as the bacterial membrane is negatively charged, they may interact and they may cause the damage to the bacterial cell, but they won't affect the host cells, which are normal cells. So next, coming to the combination therapy of this peptide and antibiotics. When they are given together, they show synergistic effect. That means they increase the effect of each other, and they prevent the bacteria to show resistance and thereby kill the bacteria, such that there is no bacteria left and the infection is cured. So there are many examples, like I mentioned. Ma'am, can you scroll down?
I've already scrolled down. Which topic do you want?
Combination therapy, ma'am.
Yeah. On my screen, it's combination therapy.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, it's visible now. So the carbapenem, when it is given in combination with polymyxin, it causes the killing of biofilm forming carbapenem resistant Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and azithromycin or vancomycin in combination with DP7. They eradicate the antibiotic resistant bacteria like Staph aureus, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and E. coli. And the next one is SEGM33 in combination with rifampicin. They are effective against negative MDR organisms like Klebsiella pneumoniae, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Acinetobacter baumannii. So hereby, it is important to select the combination. Being a clinical pharmacist, it is the responsibility to select the proper combination, which peptide will be effective with which antibiotic. That's it. Hereby, I conclude that the combination is important. Thank you.
Yeah. Sakshi, thank you. Your presentation is good.
Thank you, sir.
Your selection of topic is also good. Give some examples of peptides.
Sir, I am not able to hear you.
Give some examples of peptides.
Okay, so they are defensins and the recently developed GLK-13 and CYP-7. These are some of the recent developed peptides.
Okay, so give some combination of peptides where these systems are being used nowadays.
So I have said the carbapenem for drug resistant Pseudomonas aeruginosa and vancomycin in combination with the peptide GP13, it will eradicate the E. coli and Staph aureus resistant bacteria.
Okay, then Sakshi, thank you.
Thank you, Sakshi.